They had been tortured by the memories of recent disappointments.
It's the most remarkable comeback I have ever seen.
Maryland has been eliminated. Duke has defeated the Terrapins for the third time in four games this season.
But last week, the Terrapins wiped those memories away. Gary Williams' squad started fast and dominated inside as they throttled top-ranked Duke by 14. Maryland isn't dwelling on the past, though, even as historic Cole Fieldhouse approaches its close. They're looking to the future and a possible ACC title. But Maryland can't look too far ahead. Number 21, Wake Forest, has come to town. It's just another February afternoon in the ACC. Wake and Maryland, next on ESPN. From Cole Fieldhouse in College Park, Maryland, it's an ACC matchup between number 21 Wake Forest and the number 2 Terrapins. Hello, everybody. Mike Patrick, Len Elmore. It's great to have you with us. Wake Forest, without Josh Howard, the last four games is reeling. They've lost three of the last four, and they ran into a buzzsaw the other night against Duke.
Well, certainly, you look at those three losses, they've given up over 100 points per game, and that's where they miss Josh Howard. They miss him on the boards and on defense. High ankle sprain has kept him out of those games. He leads the conference in offensive rebounding, and he is a tremendous perimeter defender.
Maryland is on a tremendous roll. They've moved up to number 2 in the country. They've won 9 in a row. They are undefeated at home. That's pretty good stuff.
Well, it is. Their last loss was January 17 versus Duke. This is a team that's got a potent offense. They played strong D, and quite honestly, they've got supreme confidence. As you take a look at Gary Williams, and he is rolling right now.
Have a chance for the best record in school history. They only need 2 more victories for the best ACC record ever. Wake trying to hold on to third place in the ACC. Maryland hoping to solidify its grip on number 1 in the conference.
This ordinary-looking bed is the key to a restful night's sleep. Even though it may look like an ordinary mattress, it's more comfortable than you can ever imagine. Introducing the Nautilus Sleep System. Nautilus uses variable support chambers designed to let you control the comfort on your side of the bed. Individual remote controls allow you to increase or decrease the firmness on your side of the bed, so you can have that feather-soft feel and your spouse can get the extra firm support he or she has always wanted. Features like a wool blend pillow top for winter, a silk blend pillow top for summer, and our unique comfort layer make Nautilus the choice for a great night's sleep. It's time you feel the instant comfort of Nautilus with no money down and payments as low as $30 a month. Try Nautilus in your home. We guarantee the best sleep you've had in years. If you're not completely satisfied within 12 weeks, return it for a full refund of the purchase price. Call now for your free video and brochure and discover instant comfort with the Nautilus Sleep System.
Cole Fieldhouse is site. Maryland all set to host Wake Forest here on ESPN. Get ready for that. Repeat on the studio. Some other news to catch you up on. And let's begin in the Big Ten, where Indiana is in action. The Hoosiers coming in a half game in front of Ohio State for first in the conference, taking on Michigan State. Indiana has not won at Michigan State since 1991. Kyle Hornsby knocking down the three here. Indiana is up by 12. Still in the first. Hoosiers up 12. Dane Fife. Three there. Hoosiers up 15. Late first. Spartans down 10. Marcus Taylor to Al Anagonye on the inside. The big guy. A squared. Spartans down 8. Second half. Michigan State's rally continues. Anagonye closing the gap for 2. Michigan State down 4. Still second half. Hoosiers up 4. Donald Perry drives. Reverse lay-in. Hoosiers up 6. Still second half, Indiana's up 4. Jared Jeffries, the rebound. And as he puts it back, he's going to draw the foul. Up and good. Indiana up 7 after the made free throw. And on the board right now, it is a close. About as close as it can be. 4 seconds to go. Michigan State clinging to a 1-point lead. Keep you posted on that. In the NBA, the Lakers and the Knicks, for the first time since 99-2000, it's Shaq and Kobe healthy on the same court to face the Knicks in the regular season. Lakers had lost three in a row, but since then, they've won two in a row. And Kobe right there for two. Lakers up by eight. Lindsey Hunter now to Kobe. And Lindsey Hunter to Shaq. Gotten great play from Lindsey Hunter. The assist there. 4 seconds left in the first. Kobe works inside, hits the jumper as time expires. Bryant with 15 in the first half. And on the board from Madison Square Garden, the Lakers lead the Knicks 97-83, under 5 minutes to go. Shaq, 30 points and 13 boards. Sprewell for the Knicks, 22. Kobe to this point with 23. Lakers have won 7 of their last 8, as you see. Big news at the Olympics. There's been big news, it seems, every day, but the bobsled team, a U.S. bobsled team, wins a medal for the first time in 46 years. This is the four-man bobsled. USA won, driven by Hayes. Todd Hayes gets silver, and Brian Schimmer, the driver of USA 2, gets bronze. So for the first time in 46 years, the USA gets medals in bobsled. SportsCenter 7 Eastern tonight. Brian Kenny, Dave Revson, USA Canada going for the gold. Wake Forest and Maryland and the Subway 400. And we're getting ready for basketball. Juan Dixon and the Terps going to make it 10 wins in a row. Opening tap from Cole Fieldhouse coming right at you.
For the first time live and in your face in America, the WWA Revolution. See the most dangerous man in professional wrestling, Big Papa Pump Scott Steiner. Plus the long-awaited return of Randy Macho Man Savage and defending world heavyweight champion Jeff Jarrett. You'll see Chronic and Road Dog Jesse James in an action-packed initiation. Expect the unexpected and more. Coming on Direct Ticket Pay-Per-View on DirecTV, live February 24th.
Think about sports every day of the year. Men think about women every 5.3 seconds. Men think about soap? Probably never, because they're all the same. Except this one. It's new high-endurance deodorant soap from Old Spice, with scents made just for guys. So you won't smell like a bunch of wildflowers all day. Maybe now women will think about you every 5.3 seconds. Look, if you try it and you don't like it, Old Spice will buy you some of your old stuff. Guaranteed. New high-endurance deodorant soap.
Welcome back to Cole Fieldhouse in College Park. Number 21, Deacons of Wake Forest against the number 2, Maryland Terrapins. And here's the way Wake will line up. Lepore, Scott, Songalia, Downey, and Dawson. Josh Howard is going to try to play today with that high ankle sprain. He has missed 3 of the last 4 ball games. Maryland, Mouton, Baxter, and Wilcox up front. Steve Blake, the all-time assist leader. Juan Dixon in the backcourt. Gary Williams, who has now moved up to 6th all-time in conference wins, tied with Terry Holland, now in his 13th and perhaps finest year at the University of Maryland. Next to last game in this venerable old building. And we'll have over 14,000 in here today. Brings back a lot of memories, doesn't it? Here's what's happening with Wake Forest in February. 3-3, Maryland 5-0. And look at Wake Forest. They've played Cincinnati, Virginia, and Duke, and now they will add Maryland to their February schedule. It has been a brutal road for the Deacons, who are now 18-9 and 8-5 in the ACC.
Well, despite all that, Mike, I mean, Skip Frost has done a tremendous job with this Wake Forest team. At 18-9, they're still ranked. They're in the hunt with regard to NCAA first, and I think with that strength of schedule, they're pretty much a lock. And if you look at all of their numbers, you know, field goal percentage, rebound average, scoring offense, they're all up because of that up-tempo type of game he wants to play. You know, I think he's starting something proper here at Wake Forest.
Right. I agree with you, Lenny. And, of course, I think they've got that bid locked up. What they're trying to do right now is hold on to third place in the ACC for the seeding for the conference tournament, which is right around the corner. The refereeing crew today, Frank Scagliata, John Clockerty, and Leslie Jones. Very good crew.
Yeah, I'd like to think they had the bid locked up, too, but we've been surprised before. But I'm pretty much with you. Again, because of the strength of schedule, 9 losses, 18 wins. You know, above 500 record, they're pretty much there.
Of course, they'd like to add to that resume today and come in here and knock off Maryland, but the Terps are on a tremendous roll. Wilcox will jump center against Antoine Scott, 6'10 against 6'8. Baxter controls to Dixon. Maryland loves to start fast.
And starting fast, they must. Again, we talked about Wake Forest reeling in that three-game losing streak. It's not so much a streak because they did beat Virginia in the middle of that. But they've been giving up a lot of points. They're going to have to find a way to cut down on the easy opportunities.
Scott muscles his way in and gets his first bucket. Antoine Scott out of New Bern, North Carolina. We're tied at 2.
Well, interestingly enough, only Songalia and Howard have had really good games against Maryland, averaging about 13 points and 11 points respectively. The key for Wake Forest is going to be getting Craig Dawson, getting him off, because he's only averaged about 6.5 points over an 8-game stretch.
But he's number one in the ACC in 3-point shooting just like that.
You think he was listening?
I think he was. They couldn't get him free for anything against Duke the other night. Dawson shoots 42.5% from long range.
The Wake Forest in a 2-3 zone right now. Again, they want to control tempo. They also want to keep the ball from going inside to the big fellas. But Byron Mouton can do a great job for Maryland if he continues to get into the paint.
Mouton, who's been playing very well the second half of the season, gets his first bucket.
Maryland in their man-to-man. Very rarely will you see them go to zone.
Downey trying to get it back to Songalia. Blake doubles down. Songalia just so strong, even a guy as strong as Baxter can't stop him.
Songalia, the most physical player in the ACC. I love the way he uses shoulders and hips down there on the block. He gives you a clinic as far as post play is concerned. You watch him throughout this game.
His problem throughout his career has been foul trouble. He'll pick up a couple of cheapies along the way.
And I think that's why Skip Prosser has gone to zone, to protect his guys along the front line.
Teron Downey has really helped this club a lot as a point guard, and Dawson is 2-for-2 from long range.
I know he must have been reading the game notes and recognized that in 8 games throughout his career, he really hasn't done much against Maryland. He's off to a great start.
He hit 11 threes the other night against Clemson. Baxter on the way in, scores and fouls.
Take a look at a good ball movement by Wake Forest. And Dawson wide open. Juan Dixon much too late. You can't allow him to square up and get that shot off. But Lonnie Baxter inside. Nice drop step. When he uses his body, once again, it's going to be a nice battle to watch him and Songalia battle in there using those shoulders and using the hips.
Wilcox lost control of it. Got it back in the air and put it in. And drew the foul on top of it.
Well, that's a confidence breaker right there. You think you're doing everything properly on defense, and Wilcox, look at him, loses the ball, makes contact, and still able to put the ball in the basket.
And Songalia picked up that foul. Dixon tried to get the rebound, but Songalia brought it down. Lepore, great outside shooter. Too strong on that one. Baxter with a rebound.
Lepore also has to recognize when he's got a balanced floor, which means you've got people covering the board before you take that shot.
Baxter out of control, traveled. 10-8, Wake Forest by 2.
A little bit of emotion and anxiety on the part of some of the seniors out here from Maryland. Take a look at the shooting. Obviously, it's not showing.
At least not in the stroke. Songalia nearly stolen. Scott tried to keep it alive, but here comes Dixon on the miss by Downey. Blake, pull up three. He's been shooting a lot better lately. Songalia with another board.
Nice pass.
Dawson can't make a three for three, and Lepore going for the rebound will be called for a foul. That's his first, but the team's third already.
And see, Mike, I've always wondered in a situation like that, particularly Lepore knows that Baxter's in front of him. You know, you don't want to waste fouls in those situations. It's time to get back on defense.
At 6'5", how are you going to get one away from Lonnie Baxter?
Particularly when he's got position. You got to fight him. Do your homework before the shot's taken.
Without Howard, this zone defense is probably the only way Wake Forest has a chance against Maryland's inside power. Howard is an excellent defender, great leaper, but he's been bothered by that high ankle sprain, so the zone seems like a pretty good idea. They go man-to-man on the inbounds.
Well, it's his reach, his length, that really makes it difficult for opposing teams when he's on defense.
Downey, good pass to Songalia, tries to go baseline and bounced it off his foot out of bounds. Glenn, what you talked about earlier, they are giving up so many points defensively and allowing people to get good shots constantly.
And that includes the win against Virginia. But I'll tell you what, in the three losses, they were giving up over 100 points per game. You can't win like that. I don't care how good your offense is.
Juan Dixon has passed John Lucas and tied Adrian Branch on the all-time scoring charts. One more point, and he will be third only to Albert King and Len Bias.
I tell you, that's pretty strong company for Juan Dixon.
Yes, sir.
John Lucas, probably the best point guard I ever played with, both on the college and pro level.
Dixon kicks it out to Blake. Pull-up jumper by Steve Blake. Tied at 12.
Well, I tell you what, when Steve Blake makes himself a threat to go along with his passing capability, it's just really hard to stop Maryland's execution.
Just makes them such a complete team. Reach in foul on Dixon, who didn't like the call. One of the great thieves in the history of college basketball. Thought he had another one. Great start to this one. Wake and Maryland tied at 12.
How to speak Australian. Devotion. Beer. Foster's Australian for beer.
He's got the bazones from Pizza Hut in his hands. He can't handle the 51 cubic inches of Pizza Hut perfection. He can't go all the way.
$5.99 or two for $10.99.
The new bazone from Pizza Hut.
Give me a good one. Ew.
Today, one of our advisors showed this single mom that when her daughter is ready for college, she'll be ready to send her. Financially, at least.
Dear Kurt, how is training camp? Are you getting along with the other boys?
Get up, I'm going again!
This new chunky soup will fill you up right after a fun-filled day.
No!
New chunky beef rib roast with potatoes is loaded with lean chunks of savory rib roast for a taste of home while you're away.
Lights out!
I miss you, Pumpkin. Love, Mom.
You all right, Kurt?
Yeah, I'm okay.
New Campbell's Chunky Homestyle Classics.
Like Mom used to make.
Bill Pito back in the studio. Indiana, Michigan State, the Hoosiers. Final seconds, they are down three. Tom Coverdale for the tie, not there. Indiana dropping into a first-place tie in the conference with Ohio State. Michigan State wins it by three.
Thank you very much, Bill. We're tied at 12 here. Wake and Maryland, both teams getting off to a hot start. When you look at the standings, Maryland on top by a game and a loss column over Duke. Wake trying to hang on. North Carolina State playing later this afternoon against North Carolina. Wake doesn't want to drop into that third-place tie. They'd like to keep that all by themselves.
How about North Carolina State, though? I mean, they've been quite a surprise
yes,
in the conference this year. An excellent job by Herb Sendek, Anthony Grundy, and those guys. And, of course, the flip side of that is Virginia. It seems like the bottom has fallen out.
Oh.
But I tell you what, I mean, their difficulties have been on the defensive end, and if you can't guard in this conference, you can't be among the elite.
Absolutely. Hot shooting at the beginning. Wake 63%, Maryland 75%.
Maryland really extending the defense. Juan Dixon harassing folks out there on the perimeter.
Trying to get after Dawson. Songalia has to scramble to get this. Defense was what allowed them to beat Duke. They played brilliantly. Songalia traveled. Steve Blake, who has just become the all-time assist leader in the history of Maryland basketball. Baxter down the lane. Got it in foul.
I'll tell you what, Wake Forest went to a man-to-man. Maryland recognized it right away. And look at Wilcox right here. Recognizes a double. And then Lonnie Baxter comes down using his left hand, fundamentally sound. You give credit to Chris Wilcox, though. Young fella recognized the double team, stayed in control, and found the open man.
Five double-doubles in his last six games. He is trying to become only the second man in Maryland history to get 1,000 rebounds. My partner Len Elmore was the first and still the only, but they'll never touch his average, 12.2 a game. Nice move that time to get the ball inside to Dawson instead of the three-point range. He gets the layup.
Well, you like to see, if you're Skip Prosser, you like to see that dimension of Craig Dawson being able to take smaller guys inside.
Dixon, wonderful three-point shooter, short on that. Baxter with a rebound, nearly threw it away. Mouton leans into a baseline jumper. Turf fight two.
Good hustle points by Byron Mouton. Just stayed in there, didn't leak out.
Lepore for three. The Northwestern transfer drains it.
Well, I'll tell you what, Steve Lepore has been a godsend for Skip Prosser. He is a guy that's come off the bench, played hard-nosed defense, and he can pop the three.
Blake, Wilcox, great catch, and then he threw it away. Two on one. Dawson takes it all the way and scores.
Boy, Craig Dawson is alive today, man. I'll tell you, I have not seen him play like this against Maryland throughout his career. Again, always look to shoot the three. Now he's shown a multi-dimension to his game.
He has 10 of Wake's 19 points. Mouton comes down and hits a three. We're tied at 19. Boy, they're hot. Both teams hot. Mouton has hit all three of his shots from the floor and has 7 points. Dixon went for the steal, didn't get it. That leaves Lepore wide open.
Well, Maryland, I'll tell you, Maryland's got to be careful. You cannot gamble the way Wake Forest shoots from the field. I mean, they're third in the conference in field goal percentage. I'm sorry, second in the conference in field goal percentage.
Baxter walks. You know, this reminds me a little bit of the Maryland game at Duke, where they both started just so hot. Nobody missed anything.
And when you play a game like that, it's going to be decided by the little things. You know, whether or not guys cover and help themselves on defense. Who's going to stay in and hustle on the offensive glass?
Wake has turned it over only twice in this game. Maryland five times so far. Songalia goes baseline reverse and got it. Nice play by Songalia.
I tell you, quickness personified. He's going to give a clinic on the baseline and on the blocks. Keep watching him. He'll show you every move that every big man needs to know.
He doesn't look quick, but he consistently gets by people. So eventually you have to conclude that he is. 24-19. Foul's going to be on Hicks. I think he got him beyond the arc.
You see, the head and shoulders is what did it. Kind of lulled Wilcox to sleep, and then he got his head and shoulders past the man. And for all you young players, big or small, if you can get head and shoulders past your defender, you've got him on your hip. You can do anything you want with him.
Dixon hits the free throw. He's got a chance to set the all-time ACC record for single-season free throw percentage. 91-1, he leads this year. Shamon Williams of North Carolina, thousands of a percentage point ahead of him. And Dixon and Baxter were honored before the game. They had their numbers retired.
That's a tremendous honor for them, what they've done for this program during the time they've been here. And most importantly, they've been solid citizens, guys that you'd love to play with as a teammate.
You saw Hicks have the wide open three. Think about it and then take it. It usually doesn't work. Taj Holden. Juan Dixon for three.
That's not bad either. If you can throw it into him and count on a three.
Juan Dixon has 10. Crowd back into it. Songalia, nice cut, double team hammered. Nicholas and Holden both banged into him, and Taj Holden will get the call.
Well, you got to be impressed with the poise Wake Forest has shown thus far. I mean, they've taken everything Maryland's had to throw at them and held their own. And with this crowd in this place at this time,
that's right.
You know, this is about as difficult a place to play, if not the most difficult place to play in America. These guys, again, have held their poise in the half-court set. They've been finding the hot hand, and they've been able to execute very well. The question is, can they continue this, or will they wilt?
Well, especially coming off of the loss against Duke, where they were just blitzed. Duke played about as well as it could, and they just couldn't stay with them.
I guess the flip side of that is Skip probably told him again that, hey, you can't get any worse.
That's true.
Might as well give it your best.
26-25 Wake. Skip in his first year came over from Xavier. Took that program to 5 NCAA tournaments. Drew Nicholas, who has been invaluable to this team as a third guard. Dixon, that's a long three. Rebound to Antoine Scott.
Tell you, Taron Downing, who's running the offense right now, he's a pretty good story as well. He started the last 8 games, just a freshman. Took over for Broderick Hicks, and he's gotten the job done for the most part out here.
And it's benefited both of them because Hicks has played much better coming off the bench. Shot clock down to 10. Bad pass picked off by Baxter. Downey is back.
Oh, nice
and
man.
Picked it. Teron Downey with a great steal. And he walked. If it's going to be this way all day, it'll be a classic at Cole Fieldhouse. Wake by 1.
What's up, Mr. Foster?
I go in for a PC. I come out with a migraine. You ask for this, all they have is that. Makes your head spin.
Well, your computer quandary is easily solved by the folks at Dell. Just call or go online. They'll help you figure it out, so you know what you're getting and what you're getting it for.
So none of this?
Nope. Just the perfect PC for you at the right price for you.
Well, I'm feeling better already.
Good.
Steven, isn't this your father's car?
No.
Right now, a complete Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 4 processor delivering performance where you need it most is just $799. There's great deals on notebooks, too. And why wait? Because for a limited time, you can get free shipping.
You're gonna say it, aren't you?
Oh, he knows.
Easy to buy, easy to own, easy as Dell. Dell PCs use Intel Pentium 4 processors.
If you're going bald, here's good news. Rogaine, Propecia, and the latest advances in hair transplantation can restore your hair. But what's right for you? Now there's a free video that helps you decide. Call toll-free 1-888-900-HAIR for your free video from Medical Hair Restoration, the nation's leading medical group in the treatment of hair loss. That's toll-free 1-888-900-HAIR. Get the video and your hair back.
Wake Forest hanging with number 2 Maryland at home, 26-25. Juan Dixon has just become number 3 all-time at the University of Maryland. He is behind only the great Len Bias and Albert King. He has just gone by Adrian Branch and John Lucas. Pretty exclusive company.
I tell you what, though, you talk about the only player in NCAA history to have 2,000 points, 300 steals, and 200 threes. You know, that is obviously select company that he's there all by himself.
Absolutely.
It's absolutely amazing.
The only one ever. And you wonder if you'd go back and chart threes for some other guys before the line came in, if there would be some other guys on that list. but he is the only one ever to do it.
Right, and you measure steals as well.
Yeah.
But the bottom line is, since they've been doing it, this guy's made a name for himself.
Both teams shooting 71% in the first 9 minutes of this game. Baxter, great position down low. Not away from Danilus.
Also, miscommunication there. Danilus decided he was going to stay on the block and guard somebody else. And that's what I mean by the little things. Easy baskets like that will tell the difference in both these teams are counterpunching.
Josh Howard in for the first time, takes a three and misses. Here comes Dixon. Loves the open court. Baxter, as Scott fell down, and Baxter was wide open.
Well, it was right in front of the official, and he said it was a no call.
I like it when they let him play. Howard down the lane and puts it in.
Well, Josh Howard certainly missed by his team because of his ability on both ends of the floor. If he starts getting heated up, something that Wake Forest will certainly need going forward.
And Howard and Mouton are going to be talked to by John Clockerty. They shoved each other a little bit after the play, and Clockerty, nice job, stopped and said, stop the action, said, I'm not having any of this.
Well, Josh Howard has always been known to be a feisty young player. You know, the question is, you got to pick your spots. You can't do it right in front of the official.
You've got to be feisty but sneaky, right?
Yeah, that's a good combination.
Mouton doesn't get the roll. Hicks with a rebound, knocked away by Taj Holden, and then kicked out of bounds. The officials look at each other. I don't think either one of them got a good look at it, and they're going to give the ball to Maryland. I think it's the right call. Good hustle by Holden.
We're going to take a look at the replay right here. Skip Prosser is screaming that the guy's over their back. That's pretty good hands by Holden right there.
And Skip Prosser really upset. Mouton.
Oh,
what a block by Howard. And that's what Howard can do. He can really sky. They're going to call him for a foul. But, boy, you could see that coming.
Well, we're going to take a look at this play right here. I got to believe that is a good block. Well, he came across his arm after he blocks the shot. Many times, though, after you've made the play and knocked the ball away, the rest of the contact is incidental. You know, the problem that Skip Prosser probably feels is that this is all happening in front of his bench.
Yeah.
That in that situation, his team needs to get the benefit of the doubt, particularly in a close game like this.
Howard, second in offensive rebounding, fifth in field goal percentage, seventh in rebounds, nearly eight a game, eighth in steals, and he averages 14 and a half points a game, plus his presence is just as important. Songaila's going to come back in the ball game. Danilus comes out, so they switch to Lithuanians. Full court pressure here. Songaila, tough time getting it in. Now here's Howard to 2-on-1. Scott blocked by Baxter. Baxter blocked it and snatched it with one hand. What a play. That's how you get your number retired. Nicholas. Holden got it back, lost it on the way up. Here comes Wake. Dawson, he's hit three bombs. Oh, is this a good game or what?
It's fast and furious, and even the great plays haven't stemmed the momentum. Usually you make a great block or a terrific basket, it kind of stymies the other guy. Both these teams keep coming at you.
Nicholas baseline, dumps it off to Holden. Blake will try a three. We're on a pace to be 59 all at the half. Howard with a runner in the lane, got the roll. Josh Howard off the bench, having an impact. He has 4 points.
Well, that's feathery soft touch by Josh Howard. We talk about what he means to this Wake club in transition. There's nobody better.
And it's pretty obvious to the Maryland folks right now, Wake has come to play. Baxter, nice move to get inside, bucket and a foul.
But right now, Lonnie Baxter is manhandling Antoine Scott on both ends. But first, let's look at a transition right here. Howard gave it up last time to Scott. Scott got it blocked. Howard says, you know what? Sometimes, if you got to do it yourself, you're going to get it done yourself. And look at Baxter right here, just manhandle Scott. That's just muscle right there. Also a question of low center of gravity. And in this game, just like any other sport, when it's one-on-one, low man wins.
33. Both teams just shooting lights out. Dawson, he's hit three of those. Make it four.
Boy, I tell you what, Craig Dawson on pace to break his own record that he set versus Clemson not too long ago with 11 threes.
Boy, Gary Williams wants to nip that in the bud. He was really upset that Dawson was wide open on that last possession.
Can you imagine 11 threes in a game?
Mouton, partially blocked, knocked out of bounds out to the Deacons. Gary Williams upset with his club's defense, but what a start. 36-34, Wake by two.
Tonight, a night of originals on ESPN. The Block at 8, Star-Crossed, The Rise and Fall of Daryl Strawberry and Dwight Gooden. At 9, Pardon the Interruption. At 9:30, Sports Century Year in Review 1982. Then at 10, a brand new episode of Sidelines LA Hoops. Star-Crossed at 8, PTI at 9, Sports Century Year in Review 1982 at 9:30, and Sidelines LA Hoops at 10. The Block, tonight beginning at 8 on ESPN.
Regrow dense, natural hair safely and effectively, free, with Hair ZX. Like popular Foligard and Avicor, Hair ZX blends three proven formulations to produce larger, healthier hair follicles. This enables you to actually regrow your lost hair, free. Millions of people have used Foligard and Avicor because they work, gladly paying up to $110 for a month's treatment. Now you can get all the same active ingredients of Foligard and Avicor and all the same benefits free. This special free offer won't last long, so you must act immediately. Call or log on to Vitafree.com right now. Hair ZX is giving away a full 4-month supply of its proven hair regrowth product. That's a free bottle of specially formulated volumizing shampoo, free minoxidil-based hair growing solution, and free DHT blocker capsules every month for 4 full months. That's an amazing $440 value free just for calling right now. Call the toll-free number or log on to Vitafree.com now.
Bill Pito back in the studio. The Big East, it's Georgetown and Syracuse. We're in the first half off the turnover. Drew Hall for the Hoyas. Up and good and on the board. Right now, it's a 4-point Hoyas lead.
We've got a barn burner here with Wake Forest on top of Maryland, 36-34. When we're done, more ACC action. The ladies take the court. Fifth-ranked Duke at number 20, North Carolina. Off to a brilliant start, Craig Dawson, the senior's on fire, Len.
Well, he certainly is, and again, as a senior, he recognized that he hadn't had that much success against Maryland, and he's come out here with a vengeance. Again, finding his spots, his teammates are finding him squared up. You wonder, again, from Maryland's perspective, why is he so wide open? But the bottom line is, this is a guy that when he gets fired up, he can shoot lights out.
He is 4-for-5 from three-point range in this ball game. He was 0-for-4 the other night against Duke after just murdering people. Hicks will try a three. Baxter snags another rebound. That's 4 for Lonnie Baxter in the first half. 2-point game, Wake on top. Nicholas, Baxter wandered low. There's the double team, and he traveled.
Well, Lonnie Baxter is going to have to take a page out of his running partner Chris Wilcox's book. He's going to have to expect the double to come in that zone. And once he receives, you got to look for the open guy, particularly the guy coming from the high post. Wilcox was successful earlier, giving it to Baxter. Baxter's got to be just as unselfish.
A little surprising, Maryland with more turnovers than Wake early. Howard, nice dish inside. Tipped in by Songalia after Danilus missed.
Lonnie Baxter did a great job of changing Danilus's shot, but he didn't get any help.
And Wake Forest taking it to the Terps. Dixon so quick with that first step.
Again, this 2-3 zone is working for Wake. They're able to cover the wings, get a hand in people's faces, and make it difficult. Just like that.
Gala may have gotten a piece of that one. Howard on the run. Got behind a screen. Howard. And Wake Forest playing like a house of fire, 40-34. Skip Prosser has really brought his club back from that pasting they had at Duke the other night.
And again, we talk about poise, and Wake has been able to handle it, and Josh Howard's led that. I think this onslaught by Howard began when he and Mouton had that little set to. All of a sudden, he channeled that aggression into some game.
Wake Forest against the top five. You don't see any W's out there. They'd like to add that to the list today against Maryland, but that's brutal. Number five, Kansas. Number one, Duke. Number three, Maryland. Five, Cincinnati. Then Duke fell to third. They lost to them the other night. Now number two, Maryland. And they're probably going to play one or two of them more in the conference tournament. And who knows who in the NCAA.
Well, you got to believe, again, after Wake's poor showing in the tournament last year, that you build up the schedule to toughen your team up. The only thing is, they better do better in the tournament upcoming. Otherwise, how do you sell your players on that brutal schedule the next time around?
It looks like Hannibal Lecter's doing your schedule. Baxter down the lane, switches hands, can't hit it, fights for the rebound, and off of Danilus.
Yeah, Maryland's definitely going to have to engage in better ball movement. They're going to have to play a little inside out in order to get this zone out of position. Because right now, as I mentioned, they're covering the wings, and they're able to get back and limit Maryland to just one shot and out.
Dixon lost control on the way in. Excellent hands by Wake Forest defensively. Howard back the other way. Pull-up jumper. Dixon got it on the wing. Mouton wide open and still wide open. What a nice fake by Byron Mouton.
Back in the day, we used to say, watch the birdies.
Mouton has 11. Look at the length of that lob. Holy cow. Coming up at 4 Eastern on ESPN, it's a boxing special from Cincinnati. Top-ranked challengers Ricardo Williams and Anthony Washington. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. That's at 4 o'clock today.
Hey, Mike, I would have thought that that lob was for a guy like Josh Howard, but Broderick Hicks, and did he get up?
I thought it was for a guy in the third row. Wake on top by 4. The tempo has decreased a little bit.
Well, I think the zone has really set it for Wake Forest. It's gotten to their point where they run when they want to, and they've stymied Maryland's quick attack.
Lepore for 3, short, but the long rebound goes to Downey. He's fouled by Blake.
We give Teron Downey a lot of credit right now, playing against a guy as accomplished as Steve Blake. He's pretty much holding his own. That time Steve Blake forgot to block out on the long rebound.
Downey has really been wonderful out of Oxford, North Carolina. Started the last 9 ball games. He's made a difference at the point. Seems to be fearless. Goes into the lane on that one and scores.
Well, his confidence is rising, as is the rest of his teammates. The longer they stay in this game and keep this lead, the more successful they are, particularly on the defensive end, the more confident they're going to become on both ends.
Downey got 2, and really, and there is a hard foul by Danilus. I mean, a really hard foul by Danilus.
But I tell you what, and maybe it might be different if we got a chance to see it again, which we will. I think he was going after the ball, but trying to make sure also that he doesn't get it up. Quite honestly, I don't see anything wrong with that.
No, but you would acknowledge it was a hard foul.
Yeah, oh, there's no question about it. It's a hard foul. I want to make the distinction between a hard foul and a dirty play.
Absolutely.
And
absolutely.
That was exactly a hard foul. I wouldn't want it to happen to me.
I'm sure it did a couple of times.
But as fragile as I am now, I don't think I can take it.
Now, this was interesting. Songalia was walking to the other end to go to the free throw line as if to shoot a technical. Now, we'll get an explanation. There's a technical on Wilcox at the end of the play because he said something. So that will also count as a personal foul on Wilcox. He's been basically invisible so far in this game.
I remember we talked about Wake Forest poise. But right now, it's Maryland that seems to be shaking a little bit and losing their poise, particularly in a game like this. You can't afford these little mistakes. I'm going to take a look at it again right here. Good defense, good hard foul. And then if Wilcox said something, man, you got to hold your emotions in check.
And Wake is on top by 8 because Songalia, when he goes to the line, he's money. The biggest lead. And now Baxter will go to the line to shoot the free throws on the personal foul. And this is the only area where Lonnie Baxter has been suspect, shooting 59% from the floor. Maryland as a team started terribly from the line and improved dramatically as the season has gone along.
Well, it's been guys, quite honestly, that have improved, even though you say 59% for Baxter. He's improved. Chris Wilcox has improved. See?
Well, at 59%, if that's better, you know how horrible it was to begin with.
Exactly.
44-38. Can Wake Forest sustain this kind of intensity on the road? Baxter goes for the steal. Songalia to Danilo's great pass.
Told you, Songalia does it all. You know, he knows how to play. And whether it's one-on-one, whether it's turning and facing, surveying the defense and finding people, he's just absolutely too dangerous to have only one guy playing him.
Boy, and is Danilo's a good-looking freshman.
Yeah, he's another guy that has no fear.
Very smart. Juan Dixon for three. Lepore with a rebound. Lepore's done a good job on the boards.
Well, he's just played the role right now. He's done the dirty work, and when he gets an open pop, he'll take it.
Songalia goes by Randall, and Randall will be called for the foul. Ryan Randall, who came in from Allegheny Community College, has given them some bulk up front, and Gary Williams able to go effectively nine deep on that bench.
Now look right here. See Randall standing straight up. You can't guard a guy straight up like that. And look at Songalia walk the tightrope on the sideline. On the baseline, you've got to be able to get down, as I mentioned before, hand up, but lower your center of gravity when you're playing a guy like Songalia so that you can move when he moves. You stand straight up, he's going to blow by you like a hurricane.
Songalia with 10 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists in the first half. Nice move by Skip Prosser. He gets him out so he doesn't pick up a cheap foul. And Dawson buries another 3. 19 first half points for Dawson, and he's hit 5 out of 6 from downtown. And Gary Williams upset with his club. Dawson's the one guy he doesn't want to get open. And Dawson is just killing the Terps right now. And Wake is on a 16-4 run.
Well, the last shot that Dawson made was created by the gamble. Watch the gamble right there. Juan Dixon, you got to stay in front of the guy. You cannot gamble against a shooter like Dawson. All he needs is one step and a little daylight. This, again, demonstrates to me that this is the team, Wake Forest, that's holding their own as far as poise is concerned. They're in this game. Maryland's a little bit shaken, and they're doing uncharacteristic things.
Going into the Duke game, Dawson had hit 16 of his last 26 three-point shots, including 11 against Clemson. Then he was 0 for 4 against Duke. Today, he has come out, and he is back to the hot streak.
And to follow up that gamble by Juan Dixon, after the basket, none of the Maryland players stayed around to help Steve Blake inbound the ball, and Gary Williams had to call that timeout. He wanted to talk to his team. Lonnie Baxter finally did get there. But again, their minds are someplace else right now.
Well, they better get back here because Wake Forest is playing them off their feet. Blake, nice crossover to get free from 16.
Well, he's a leader out there. That's a guy that'll jog you back to where you need to be.
Blake trying to put some defensive pressure on Downey. Teron Downey with a runner. Randall with a rebound. Blake trying to push it. Wake gets back. Baxter leans into one. That's his favorite move. Just sort of sweeps across the lane.
Well, he gets his shoulders and head past Scott. Scott doing too much standing around instead of trying to beat Baxter to the spot. That's going to be there all afternoon.
Lonnie Baxter has 15. Randall reaches in, knocks it away. The crowd in a frenzy right now as Maryland tries to crank it up on defense. What a first half. 2:44 to go. It's already 49-42.
Buying a house can be rough. At Coldwell Banker, we can't do enough. Agents are caring and not overbearing. We'll find you a house that you love.
A Coldwell
Coldwell Banker agent is your perfect partner. They're with you every step of the way. And when you're buying a home, they'll bend over backwards for you.
Coldwell Banker, we sure know our stuff.
You know, ideas and inventions come from people in all walks of life. Do you have an idea for a new product or invention? If so, Invention Submission Corporation has information to help you get started. ISC is America's largest inventor service firm. Call now and learn how to submit your idea to companies through ISC's data bank and apply for a patent. Even if your idea is just to improve an existing product, call for ISC's free information.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-554-9000.
Well, I'm here in the Virginia Beach oceanfront, soaking up some rays with Becky here. You having a good time, Becky?
Oh, yeah, it's a great beach.
Now, what if I were to show you a whole bunch of great things you could do besides sit on the beach? Would you maybe want to come back a little sooner than next summer?
Sure.
Not great. Well, if you call this number right here on the screen.
Where?
Right, excuse me?
What number?
What if I were to tell you that simply by calling this number on the screen...
What screen?
Where?
You see it, don't you? Call the number on the screen, they'll shoot one right out to you.
Just tap this one?
All right, I'll call the number. Bill Pito back in the studio as we check out Xavier and Duquesne. In transition for Xavier, David Young all alone. Up and down easily. Xavier by 20 first half.
Well, with Wake leading Maryland by 7 here at Cole Fieldhouse, we've had a chance to see ACC basketball at its best. The strength of Baxter, the athleticism of Howard, and the pure shooting prowess of Craig Dawson. Dawson's been the story, and you talk about being white hot. He's gotten the job done from the perimeter.
The game summary, look at the shooting percentage. 63 for Wake, 7 out of 15 from outside. Maryland is down 5 3-point shots, and Dawson already has 19 points in the first half. Lonnie Baxter already has 15.
Well, I will say this again. I talk about ACC basketball. That's what it symbolizes. You know, strength, athleticism, shooting, skills. I mean, these guys out here right now, particularly Wake Forest, just have not backed down.
Dawson with another one. Craig Dawson with 22 points in the half. Are you kidding?
And the thing about it is he's gotten so much daylight.
That was a set play off of a timeout. Blake short. He's hit 6 out of 7 bombs. Hicks, basket and a foul on Blake.
What a finish.
Wake Forest is cooking.
I'll tell you what, Broderick Hicks, you mentioned it, coming off the bench, he's got new life as a player. And here, supreme confidence going to the basket, particularly on the finish, strength up top. And I'll tell you what, getting Maryland on their heels is what Wake Forest has done right now. And they're looking to kind of lower the boom.
Since he's been coming off the bench, he's averaged nearly 15 points a game. Some guys just seem to be much more comfortable in that role.
But sometimes you sit there, you can gain perspective after the first couple of minutes, know who's out on the floor, see yourself exploiting those opportunities. Then when it's time to come on the floor, you just live what you thought.
And guess what? Maryland is number one in the conference in field goal percentage defense. They are number one in the conference in three-point percentage defense. Both are really being shredded today.
Well, it's the zone that Wake Forest has played that's covered the shooters, limited the inside touches, and really stymied Maryland's ability to penetrate.
Howard, Lotus, and Guile. Double team back to Hicks. Hicks just sort of tossed that one up. Taj Holden with a rebound. Here comes Drew Nicholas ahead to Baxter. Nice play by Nicholas. Good catch by Baxter.
So far, that's been Maryland's best opportunity to keep Wake out of the zone, get it in transition. But in order to do that, you've got to be able to stop Wake on the other end.
Baxter has 17 points, and Howard is fouled in the lane. Coming up on the Super 8 halftime report, Bill Pito will be along. The Accenture Championship plays on. We'll have top 25 men's hoops for you. Last foul was on Mouton. That's the Mass Mutual halftime report. Howard goes to the line. Homegrown Winston-Salem. Last year he made second team all ACC.
Boy, that was way off.
And he gets it badly, and then he missed that. What hustle by Howard, and it was so easy he just blew it.
and no blockout. Boy, if he had scored, I think Gary Williams would have hit the roof.
He would have gone right through the roof. You wouldn't have had to wait to close Cold Field House. It would have been closed today. How the shooter can get to the baseline to get his own rebound on a missed free throw. Well, they could show that in the film study for a long time.
Well, the thing about the shooter, when you're off, you know it's off. But this should be a guy right at the top to block you off the board because of that fact.
What a first half. 58.7 seconds to go. Wake is on top by 10. And a couple of individual performances in this first half have been absolutely awesome. Dawson with 22. He's bombed away from inside. Baxter leads Maryland with 17. Of course, he's done almost all of his damage very close to the basket. But Wake leads by 10. Maryland doesn't look tired. They don't look lethargic. They seem to be playing pretty well. But Wake, this is very much like Duke and Wake the other night. Wake came out, played pretty well, still got killed.
Well, I'll tell you, the thing about Wake this point in time is that they've forced 10 turnovers. They've had an opportunity to set up this zone and slow Maryland's attack, cover the shooters when they need to. It's almost as though they're willing to give Baxter some baskets if they can shut off this perimeter attack. And then on the other end, running in transition, they've been just a little bit too quick for Maryland.
Nicholas guarded by Downey. Ooh, big screen by Wilcox.
Nice step out by Songalia to stop Nicholas from turning the corner.
Lonnie Baxter has to adjust his path. It doesn't matter. Lonnie Baxter, 19 and a half.
And that's what I'm talking about. It seems as though Wake is willing to allow Baxter to get off, but they're making sure on the perimeter end that guys like Juan Dixon and others are shut down.
Maybe a pretty good theory.
So far, can't argue with it.
Because Baxter's going to make twos and not threes. They can almost hold for the last shot. Downey looking for the screen, gets it back to Songalia, 12-footer, and Songalia, a much better shooter than people think, knocks that down, 56-46. Dixon, good if it goes. And what a first half for Wake Forest. They come in to number two's home and play them off their feet. 56-46, Wake at the half. We're back in College Park, Maryland, where the second-ranked Terrapins trail by 10, 56-46 at the half. It has been a scoring machine for Wake Forest. Dawson with 22. Awesome.
Well, Craig Dawson only missed one shot from the field. And again, you take a look at his numbers, 22 points today. Lonnie Baxter, on the other hand, he's only missed one shot from the field. 7 rebounds, 19 points, but 5 turnovers. But right here, Lonnie Baxter doing the job against Antoine Scott. Really had his way, putting it on the floor as well. But when you talk about Craig Dawson, again, coming into this game, only 6.5 points against Maryland throughout his career. He has certainly found the range, and you wonder how he's been so wide open.
Wake shoots 63%. They hit 50% from long range. Maryland turned it over 10 times. Howard able to play some after missing 3 of the last 4 games with that high ankle sprain. He's contributed 6 points, but it is lights out shooting for the Wake Forest team and Deacons.
Well, I tell you, Josh Howard, those numbers don't reflect what he's added for this team. On the defensive end in that zone, he's contested a lot of shots, made it difficult. On the offensive end in transition, he's been a threat coming full speed against the Maryland defense. But the key to this game, Maryland has 10 turnovers. Off those turnovers, Wake Forest has scored 16 points. Maryland's got to take better care of the ball, and they've got to stop some folks. Again, we talk about Josh Howard, what he's done. You look there, again, the athleticism. Here he is running the break right now down the lane. A couple of times he's dished it off and found some people as well. So, again, Josh Howard's presence on the floor has actually made Wake obviously much more confident in what they're capable of doing.
You think they're interested in this down in Durham, North Carolina?
I don't think they left for halftime for fear of missing something.
Wake gets the ball to start the half. Fans trying to encourage the Maryland defense. I thought on that last shot Dawson made, Gary Williams was going to come out and cover him. Downey gets the opening bucket. The lead's up to 12.
Nice back door there, using Maryland's aggressiveness, trying to get into the passing lane against him.
Wilcox gets the roll.
Only his second field goal today. This is a guy that has to get started for Maryland. Give him kind of a double threat down on the block.
Blake twisted his ankle and went down. Downey will fire a three. Scott with a big rebound. And then he lost it out of bounds. See if Blake's all right. He appears to be. If Maryland should go on to lose this game, it lets Duke back in it to share the conference title if they can win the rest of their games. Baxter with the bucket. Lonnie Baxter now with 21. It's the way you're supposed to play the day they retire your jersey. Scott trying to do too much, stripped on the way up. Blake open for three. Wilcox rebound. Blake again. Wilcox. He's hit two in a row, and here come the Terps.
Well, if you wait for us, you knew that the turtle wouldn't sleep too long.
And Skip Prosser wants to stop it right now. A 6-0 run. He'll take a timeout to talk to his kids. 18:40 left in the game. It's down to six.
Now there's a better way to soothe your skin after shaving. Nivea for Men Aftershave Balm has advanced moisturizers and vitamins to soothe and improve your skin. Nivea for Men. More evolved skincare.
Pizza Hut kicked it to me, now I'm kicking it down to you. The new Pizzone. If the Pizzone was a shoe, it'd be like the size 14 triple E. 51 cubic inches of perfection.
Oh, wow, that's a big shoe.
$5.99 or two for $10.99. The new Pizzone from Pizza Hut.
It's time to redo the kitchen.
Let's get that home equity loan.
It's the Hendersons.
Get him a great deal.
Partrick Bank's on the job.
So's Ferguson Bank.
We need a lower rate.
Want banks to compete for your home equity loan? Come to LendingTree.com. Fill out one form and get up to four offers within hours. When banks compete, you win at LendingTree.com.
If you suffer from any of these health problems, a Craftmatic adjustable bed with built-in massage and soothing heat may provide the temporary relief from pain you've been looking for. Call now and we'll mail you this special free $200 off rebate certificate. It's good for $200 off the Craftmatic Model 1 bed of your choice. Don't suffer needlessly. Get the facts about the affordable adjustable beds that may provide temporary relief.
Call toll-free 1-800-544-1000.
Wake Forest has seen its lead cut to six with 18:40 to go in the game. Let's take you around the rest of the ACC. North Carolina State now 8-6, trying to move into third with Wake, their most conference win since 91. Virginia has imploded. They've lost two. Oh, they've won only two games in their last nine. They still have to face Duke and Maryland again. And Edward Scott bidding to become the first Clemson player ever to lead the ACC in assists. He's ahead of Steve Blake right now, 7.9. He has been brilliant this year.
I'll tell you what, that NC State story is a terrific story. Supposedly Herb Sendek was under pressure, and he has responded, his team has responded with an exciting year. But speaking of exciting, I tell you what, Skip Prosser absolutely had to tell his guys that, look, Maryland was going to make a run at you. It came. Now you got to show some poise. We talked about it in the first half.
Wake has turned it over twice in its first three possessions of the half. This is what Maryland was able to do against Duke, just play intense defense.
And again, in this place with this crowd, it's going to be a true test of character.
There's another steal. Dixon to Blake. They're on their feet at Cole.
Looks like the meltdown starting.
Dawson, tough three. Under pressure, missed everything.
Skip Prosser telling them, calm down, guys.
They are shaking right now.
And it's not just from the vibrations of this crowd
no.
either.
Although that would be enough. Maryland hits four of its first five. Wake one of four. And the only good shot they got was to start the half with a layup. Blake to bring it up against Hicks.
And the Terps
Prosser brings the senior in at the point.
Terps obviously playing the way they have always wanted to play. A little bit of inside, a little bit of outside. Aggressive play going to the basket. Steve Blake has led that effort.
Daniluce picks up the foul, his second. Blake telling his teammates the play he wants.
The foul's on number 13. It is Daniluce, his second, first on the team.
Dixon.
Did you see the way he fought off Craig Dawson? Still able to receive and score. That's desire, folks.
58-56. To 10-0 Maryland run. Wake needs to get a good shot. Howard under pressure and made it. That's a tough shot.
You want to know what Josh Howard brings to the table? Picture's worth a thousand words on that one.
Ice water. Mouton too strong. Wilcox kept it alive but snagged by Dawson. Nice kick out. Hicks goes into the lane. Good fake scoop shot. Won't go. Songalia tried to keep it, or Daniluce tried to keep it alive and couldn't. Mouton again. Got that one. Byron Mouton has 14. He averages 11 and a half. It's down to one. Howard. Two air balls in the last three shots, and Howard thought he was fouled.
Well, he wasn't fouled on the last one. Made a big shot. Keep his guys focused. But Byron Mouton, you talked about him. Again, he averaged 16 points and 7 rebounds over the last 7 games and shooting a high percentage.
Maryland with a chance to take the lead. 3 seconds. Lonnie Baxter camped in the lane. Gary Williams did not like the call.
Well, on the shot before that, when Howard went up and shot the air ball, obviously Wake thought that he had gotten fouled. No call. And I'm sure what's going on in Gary's mind is, are we evening things up now? John Clockerty, too good a referee for that, though.
Coaches never think they get a break. Songalia missed the wide-open 14-footer. Blake, head up all the way. Just spun out. Maryland can't quite get over the hump. Howard down the lane. Great job by Songalia, who sealed off the lane and gave him a path to the basket.
How about that crossover, though? Josh Howard again.
30.
The big shots when they're needed. He's the man.
I mean, Songalia opened up that side of the lane like floodgates. Wilcox tries to go low to Baxter. Not a good decision by Wilcox. Hicks steps out around the screen. Wake by 3. Daniluce, he'll try a 16-footer. Saved by Dixon. Feel a little tension in here right now?
It's starting, that's for sure. The perspiration starting to amass. And I bet under that Gary Williams jacket at the floodgates opening.
Dixon, what a tough shot! Dawson back the other way, tried to get it to Daniluce, knocked away by Wilcox.
Hey, Dawson had Daniluce. It was that one bounce that hurt him.
14:48 to go. A standing ovation for the Terps. They've come back to within one.
How to speak Australian. Laundromat.
Cheers, mate.
Beer. Foster's Australian for beer.
This afternoon, one of our advisors showed this dad how to protect his family. and still retire at 55.
Here, there's a new chunky soup.
Mom?
Huh? Don't fumble that bowl, baby.
Whoa.
Chunky Chicken and Dumplings is loaded with big chunks of chicken, veggies, and hearty home-style dumplings to fill you up right.
Hey, your head's on my shoulders.
Your head's on my shoulder, man.
Dumplings.
New Campbell's Chunky Home-Style Classics.
Like Mom used to make.
Tonight, the Clippers hit the road, and the young team adjusts to life on the run in the NBA.
They have a lot more young talent than the Knicks, that's for sure.
Sidelines LA Hoops, presented by Gatorade, 10 p.m. tonight, part of The Block on ESPN.
Bill Pito back in the studio. They're playing for Olympic hockey gold. USA on the board first. Tony Amonte made it one zip, but Paul Kariya just scored for Team Canada. 1-1, first period.
Wake Forest is led by as many as a dozen. The lead is down to one, 62-61 over second-ranked Maryland. The bench with Josh Howard coming off the bench. He had missed three of the last four with that high ankle sprain. In the last meeting, Maryland had an 11-point advantage. Today it's 14-0 Wake Forest. That's a staggering statistic because Maryland's bench has delivered all season long.
Well, he's a tough matchup any way you slice it, whether he starts or comes off the bench. But the thing he's been able to give to Wake Forest today, particularly during this bad stretch for them, is the ability to create a shot. Now, Maryland's defense has stymied their patterns, not able to get it into Songalia or some of the big guys across the front line, certainly not able to get it to Dawson where he needs it. But Howard's the guy who creates offense.
Wake Forest field goal shooting has cooled off in the second half. Maryland shooting 70%. Danilus got his own rebound. Danilus got it again. Tipped in by Howard. Boy, they just kept fighting inside.
We give Danilus a lot of credit for perseverance. A lot of guys would go up once and keep their hands down at their sides and hope that something good happens.
Danilus has a dozen. Nicholas in the ball game. Blake for three, didn't get it. Howard back the other way. Boy, they're a different team with him in there.
Oh, they are. Again, his athleticism makes everybody a threat because of his ability to create. Nice spin right there.
Whoa. Oh, man. Was the call a travel?
Yes.
Baxter got away with a push. Watch this.
Yeah, I don't know. It looked as though he might have picked up that pivot foot, but that was very close.
Baxter goes baseline, got all the way underneath and got the bounce.
That's a great job of Lonnie Baxter, kind of doing his Songalia imitation.
Lonnie Baxter has 23. They've cut it to one. He's at 10 out of 11 shots. Howard for three, another air ball, but off Wilcox out of bounds. And Skip Prosser really upset. He thinks Howard's been fouled twice in a row on those threes.
Well, that time Songalia went down the lane and his jersey all of a sudden got ripped around the other way. There's a lot of holding going on, a lot of bumping. You know, you kind of hope that the officials start to call it closer right now.
A foul on Dixon right there.
Got to keep it under control.
First team foul against Maryland. Wake has committed one here in the half. ...13-32 to go in a big, big ball game. Songalia down the lane, pulls up. That's going to be goaltending on Wilcox. Just can't get there that late.
Right, good call by the official. Take a look right here. Songalia loses the handle, doesn't really get it off. Yeah, that was on the way down. Not only you can't get there that late, you can't get it. Nobody gets up that high.
That's right.
And you can tell Wilcox was thinking about that play. You got to put those things behind you.
And Gary Williams going to get Taj Holden in for Wilcox.
Chris Wilcox, a terrific player, terrific young player, and that's the operative word, young.
Yep.
As he gets more experience, obviously he's going to be even more devastating than he already is.
Hicks outside, dogged by Blake. Tough matchup for Nicholas here with Howard. Songalia wheels into the lane, got Baxter off his feet, missed a shot. Wilcox rebound.
So that's where Wilcox's ability as he develops it to shoot that 18-footer would pay dividends. Had a wide open shot there.
Blake, nice job to get to the baseline. Leaves Juan Dixon open, and Dixon spins one out. Dixon almost took it away from Hicks. Somehow Hicks got it back. It's 5-on-4. And Hicks slashes underneath. Songalia, nice fake, and got Baxter in the air for the foul.
But what an effort by Juan Dixon in the backcourt. Just had an opportunity and just missed the opportunity for that steal.
It's pretty quick, isn't he?
I'm telling you. And, you know, you got to be aware of where he is on the floor. You cannot relax. And that puts a lot of mental pressure on a ball handler. You talk about physical fatigue. Now, you combine that with the mental fatigue of having to know where he is at all times. If you can survive that, you will have done something.
The numbers on Songalia, 14 points, 5 rebounds. Dixon, number 2 all-time in steals at Maryland behind Johnny Rose.
You get the feeling that Skip Prosser's enjoying this game.
Wouldn't you?
As long as I'm on the winning side, it wouldn't be agony. But I think both coaches are enjoying it.
Songalia knocks down both free throws.
And you got to love it when you see both teams playing at the height of their ability.
Well, we certainly do. I know that. This is fun. Got Wake Forest zone. Nicholas fires over it. One and done for the Terps. Howard leans into a baseline jumper. Can't get it. Here comes Dixon. Blake left alone. Didn't want the shot. Taj Holden, he's got range.
Well, Taj Holden's been a bench force all year. And I think that's the first three-pointer that he's taken since January 31st at Virginia, where he was missing from out there, decided to step into the paint, and was very successful. And from then on, he started playing inside the paint. But when you get an open one like that, you know you can knock it down, take advantage.
Wake by 2. Dixon has not done it, or Dawson has not done anything in the second half.
Well, you had to believe that the first thing Maryland spoke about in the locker room at halftime was find that guy, number 42.
A 2 would tie it, a 3 would take the lead. Blake, they switched, and then everybody left him alone, and Blake recognized it.
Well, Mike, we talked about Wake giving up over 100 points per game in their 3 losses most recently. You can see why with the breakdown defensively.
And then Maryland throws it away. Dawson back the other way, left alone for 3. And Dawson, who had 22 in the first half, finally gets an open look. And I mean open. Dawson, 71-68 Wake Forest. What a great ball game this has been. Nicholas open. Baxter leans into a double team.
That time was a mismatch. Howard playing Lonnie Baxter. Again, great recognition by Maryland to spread the floor and give Baxter some room to work before the double team came.
Danilus picked up that last foul. 10-10 to go in the game. Still a 3-point Deacon lead.
People want to win. And we don't get there with milk and cookies.
On Sunday, March 10th.
I've never had a team play scared. What the hell are you scared of?
The first original motion picture from ESPN.
I had to sit around for a year with a losing record. I'm not going to let you people do that to me.
Brian Dennehy is Bobby Knight.
Don't you kids get it? Playing my game is what got you here.
A season on the brink. Sunday, March 10th, 8 p.m. Eastern. Only on ESPN.
Viewer discretion is strongly advised. Want to play better golf?
Well, you could spend hundreds of dollars for lessons, or for only $1.32 a lesson, you can learn from the game's top pros and teachers when you subscribe to Golf Magazine. Call now, and you'll also receive this great Golf Magazine gear bag free with your paid subscription. Learn how to get more distance, straighten your slice, sharpen your short game, perfect your putt, and more. No matter what your level, you'll enjoy the game more because you'll play better with Golf Magazine. It's the game's most widely read publication because it's written for today's kind of golfer, along with lessons from the pros and Golf Magazine's top 100 teachers. You'll get full coverage of the pro game in Tour Talk, great new courses you can play on, the best deals exclusively for Golf Magazine readers, plus equipment reviews and so much more. Call now for 12 issues of Golf Magazine for just $1.32 an issue. That's a 67% savings off the cover price. And you'll also get this roomy Golf Magazine gear bag with separate shoe compartment and a convenient bottle holder, free. You'll love golf more when you improve your game with lessons from the best in the business. Golf Magazine. Call now.
Wake trying to pull the upset here at Maryland, up 71-68. When we're done, more ACC action. The ladies take the court. Fifth-ranked Duke at number 20, North Carolina. Duke 15-0 in conference play, trying to join the 1995 Virginia Cavaliers as the only teams to go undefeated in the ACC. And there are the standings. Duke with a four-game lead in the loss column over North Carolina. Really, they're just going for history today and in that rivalry game as well.
Boy, how about that? Two dominant teams down there in Durham.
Against Duke, Wake Forest shot 33%, turned it over 20 times. That just killed them. Today, hitting 52%. That's down from what they were hitting early. And 11 turnovers. They had 33% against Duke, the worst they shot all year.
Well, I tell you, you can attribute that to improvement on the Wake side, because certainly they're not seeing any less pressure from Maryland.
Absolutely.
Wake sticking with that 2-3 zone, looking to extend it a little bit. They're going to have to start covering shooters and cut off the drive, but boy.
Ryan Randall on the pass from Blake, and at the 10-minute mark, it's a one-point game.
And if you crack the door open, Steve Blake is walking in, handing out assists.
Dawson around a screen. He has been brilliant today. Craig Dawson with 27 points. Had his career high against Clemson when he had those 11 threes. Went for 38. Lead has been as many as 12 for Wake. Mouton. And Lepore is going to be called for riding Taj Holton out of there. Dawson, there's the numbers against Clemson. 11 of 17 from long range. Today, 7 of 9.
You know Lepore certainly has to block out. He's undersized in there against the Taj Holton. And you want to hold your block out.
He just kept riding him toward the parking lot. Blake kicks it out to Mouton for three. Good hustle by Downey. Blake got it back, and then it's off of Downey out of bounds. Steve Blake created that just the way he created the play at the end of the half against Duke. Just a brilliant play to go out when Jason Williams turned his head to steal the ball. Randall tried to get it back inside, turnover Terps.
Boy, it's a good thought because Wake totally forgot the inbound passer.
Lepore open for three. Scott kept it alive, but Holden gets the rebound.
Maryland's bench may not be giving them a lot of points, but I'll tell you what, they're giving them all the hustle plays. On the boards, deflecting balls, making steals. You don't measure that on the stat sheet, except when guys like Mouton get an opportunity to score. But give credit to Randall, to Holden. And right here, Steve Blake, once again, we told you, all he needs is a sliver of room, he'll find you. And that makes guys want to run.
Steve Blake has a chance to join names like Hurley, Corciani, and Cota in the all-time assist leaders, not only, as Lepore goes out with his fourth, not only the top three in ACC history, the top three in the history of college basketball, and at his current rate, Blake would get close next year as a senior.
Well, again, I mean, I just love the fact that he's out here playing in a pass-first, shoot later type of mode. He's the guy that's the glue for this team. And as I said, you love playing on the floor with him because if you run, you work to get open, he'll find you.
Dawson. Dixon's tried to stay in his hip pocket. Howard double teamed and fouled.
Boy, I tell you what. Again, Josh Howard getting into the paint, creating problems for Maryland's defense, although on that one, Ryan Randall would have been just as well served just to get his hands up and force Howard to shoot open.
Howard goes to the line, 65% shooter. Very unusual to see a guy 6'6", 200 pounds, be among the top 10 steals leaders, but he is. Very quick hands, excellent shot blocker. And coming off the bench, this shows you how much they've missed him. He's working on a double-double.
Well, he's got tremendous anticipation in the passing lanes. When you have that kind of reach, you know, the passer doesn't believe you can get there, and he misjudges your reach, and Howard's off to the races the other way.
Every time Maryland makes a run, Wake responds. Back to a three-point lead as we approach 8 minutes.
And again, I go back to that magical word, poise, in a situation like this. Wake has held it. They may have bended a little bit, but they have not broken.
Juan Dixon with a three. We're tied. Dixon has 17.
Yes.
Right. Just another lousy afternoon in the ACC. Songalia wants the ball, and they get it to him against Holden.
Nice pass.
Great pass. And a foul as Scott was hammered from behind.
Darius Songalia not afraid to turn and face the defense. And again, Antoine Scott with a nice cut down the lane.
Boy, the crowd again, didn't like it, but he got hammered.
Oh, he did. And the thing that helped him was he went to the basket strong. He wanted to dunk that ball. If he had gone in a half step, he might not have gotten that call.
Wake Forest, number two is the team in free throw shooting. They're very good. They've hit 9 out of 11 today. Maryland hitting two-thirds of its shots, 8 out of 12.
Well, I'll tell you what, a well-deserved hand for Nicholas, Randall, and Holden going back to the bench. They just did a terrific job for Maryland.
It's a great bench that Gary Williams just put together. Wake still hanging on. They're up by two.
Oh, the shark has pretty teeth, dear. And he shows them a pearly white.
It's called jazz. And now, all the best jazz is together in one collection.
Tall and thin and young and lovely. The girl from Ipanema goes walking.
Time Life Music presents the Classic Jazz Collection. Count Basie, Billie Holiday, Nat King Cole.
Get your kicks on Route 66.
Dave Brubeck. Get classic jazz on two CDs or two cassettes. Stan Getz, Miles Davis, Ella Fitzgerald.
It don't mean a thing if it ain't.
Then audition other great jazz albums. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Miss the Saturday dance.
So call now and get two albums of classic jazz.
To order classic jazz, use your credit card and call 1-800-792-4523 or send $19.99 for two CDs or two cassettes plus $3.99 shipping to Classic Jazz, Department 3, Richmond, Virginia, 23280 or order online at timelife.com.
Bill Pito back in the studio as we update the Big East, Georgetown and Syracuse. Mike Sweetney on a miss here. Close game, two-point game inside of 10 minutes to go. Craig Forth for Syracuse, a freshman, jams it down. All tied up, 49-all. Xavier Duquesne, old Xavier, 73-52, under 7 to go in that one.
7:36 to go in a beauty. Wake Forest on top of Maryland, 77-75. Mike Patrick, Len Elmore with you against the top five. No success this year for Wake. Lost to Kansas, Maryland, Cincinnati, and Duke twice. playing Maryland again for the second time. Of course, they're going to be in the NCAA tournament barring some kind of disaster. But this would be a quality win for them, certainly.
And that's certainly what they need, again, from a seeding perspective. You know, you take a look at that schedule. Strength of schedule is a lock. But, again, if you can get a win against a team like Maryland, ranked number two, high RPI at their place, I mean, you're talking something right now. People start to believe that you're among the quality teams.
Well, strength of schedule doesn't get much better than that. And here's a foul away from the ball. Teron Downey is going to be called for a hold. That's his first. Maryland hasn't led in this game since it was 34-33. Or is it Hicks? It is Hicks. That's three on Hicks. Songalia ties up Baxter. And the possession arrow will give it to Maryland. That's why I continue to despise that possession arrow. There you just made a defensive play, and it does you no good whatsoever.
I think the object is that they will all even out at the end of the game.
Yeah, right.
Two-sided coin.
Doesn't seem to work that way.
Well, it doesn't. You know, it compounds when players, when they get into a tie-up situation and gain a bit of possession, they all of a sudden call timeout.
Yeah.
To me, that's the worst play in college basketball, particularly if you're not aware that the arrow's pointing in your favor.
Here's the lob inside Baxter. Tip back out Wilcox. Loose ball, new shot clock at 6:54. Break for the Terps. They defended that lob well. Got a mismatch, and Blake will take a three. Wake Forest basketball. Maryland just can't get over the hump. They get close. They tied it five times, or cut the lead to one five times, and tied it twice, but haven't been able to lead here in the half. Songalia, great backdoor cut to Howard, and fouled by Mouton. What a play.
Well, I tell you what, you give Darius Songalia, we gave him credit the last time for facing the defense and making a pinpoint pass. Watch this. Again, at the top, Howard comes out to the wing. Mouton turns his head, and it's good night. And once again, this is the pressure release. If Maryland's going to play tough on the wings and deny, you better be careful of that backdoor situation.
6:27 to go in the game. And, Len, how huge is, you see, Howard was 16-7. The psyche of a basketball team going into the conference tournament and then the NCAA tournament. This is a team that, when it is faced truly the best in the country, has lost. To be able to come to Maryland, a team that is arguably as hot as anybody in the country, playing as well as anybody in the country, and be able to play this well, and if they can win, what a boost psychologically it would be.
Well, certainly, and particularly you have to appreciate the fact that they just got spanked by Duke so hard that that spot is still red. And they come out here on this floor and maintain their poise in the face of a tremendous Maryland onslaught. You just got to give them credit. And if they can carry this on, win this game, and then finish up strong with Georgia Tech and NC State going into the ACC tournament, I'd be very wary if I'm Maryland or Duke and playing this team again before they get to the final.
Howard missed the free throw. Maryland trying to cut into a four-point lead with 6:19 to go. Mouton low, fadeaway over Howard, fouled by Howard.
One of the few mistakes Josh Howard has made all afternoon in fouling the jump shooter. We talked about his reach. You know, that's a tremendous obstacle for anybody to shoot over. He's at the reach of a seven-footer, and you don't have to slap
right
down and go after the guy's hand.
Mouton, the 6'6 senior from Louisiana, hits his first free throw. He's hit three out of four from the line and could cut it to two right here. Dawson, who got a nice rest, will come back in, and Downey will go out. So Hicks will stay on the floor to run the offense.
I mean, the object is Mouton's about a 70% free throw shooter, but shooting 48, 49% from the field, I'll take my chances from the field.
That's right. 79-77. Blake went for the steal, didn't get it. With Songalia working hard to get the ball down low against Baxter. Got by him, tries to reverse, switches hands, and scores. What a play. 18% dial.
I tell you what, NBA scouts, if they're watching, this kid doesn't go in the top six, they all need their heads examined.
Yeah, somebody missed something. Wilcox, tough shot. Boy, they're showing us everything today, Len.
Speaking of a future pick,
yeah,
Chris Wilcox, he's got some polish needed to his game, but I can tell you that the next year or two, he's going to be one of those top picks as well.
81-79, Dawson, good fake to get it to Songalia, steps into the lane and scores against Baxter. He against Baxter and Baxter against him, they're almost unstoppable.
So tough.
Songalia has 20. What a great game. There's Baxter.
Well, I'll tell you the difference right now is Songalia defensively, that's his liability. Lonnie Baxter's so good at getting body position.
Right.
He just seals them off, vacuums in the pass, and makes the shot.
Howard to Dawson. Made a nice move to put Dixon on Dawson here in the second half. Give him a little more quickness. So at least Dawson just doesn't eat you alive. Hicks, under pressure, just sort of tossed that one up with the right hand, and we've got a foul inside on the rebound. That's going to be on Howard, I believe. That's three on Howard. And that was the 17th foul against Wake, so we'll shoot one and one, and Maryland will have a chance to tie it at the line.
Well, I tell you, if this gets to be a free throw parade going down the stretch, you know, Maryland's going to have to hope for some luck. Some of their key guys are shooting under 60%. Talking about Baxter, we're talking about Wilcox. You know, only Blake and Juan Dixon are outstanding free throw shooters. On the other side of it, though, Wake's got a number of guys shooting in the 80s, 70s, and 80s.
Wilcox misses the front end of the one and one.
And these are the little things we're talking about that might be the difference.
Hicks slashes to the basket. Howard, loose ball rebound. And he's bumped by Wilcox, and Wilcox will get the foul. And the reason they called that a foul is the player was knocked out of bounds, and you can't turn around and say, well, you can't keep the ball, so it's got to be a foul.
Well, there's no more force out. And
that's
where,
right,
where there's contact, it's either got to be a foul or it's got to be a no call, in which case the ball goes the other way.
That was only the sixth team foul against Maryland. Songalia held by Baxter. And Lonnie Baxter just had a big old bear hug on him. Two on Baxter. Or it's on Daniels. Jeez. And then Lonnie turns his head and says, who, me? Never touched him. You remember that, don't you? Never touched him?
Who, me?
Yeah. Daniels hits the free throw. Good-looking 6'8 freshman. Moved into the starting lineup recently. Wake now 11 out of 14 from the free throw line. Daniels gets the roll, and it's back to four. You just get the feeling if Maryland could ever get the lead in the second half, they might spurt way out ahead, but they can't get the lead.
Well, one of the things that Maryland's done in this half is really cut down on the number of turnovers.
Baxter tried to keep it alive and couldn't. And Hicks is going to reset his offense. 4:13 to go. More than 14,000 on hand next to the last game in the history of Cold Fieldhouse in Wake Forest, trying to make it an unpleasant memory.
Nice read by Chris Wilcox on the backdoor attempt. But again, Maryland in this half has cut down on the turnovers, only five, as opposed to 10 in the first half, where Wake Forest got 16 points off of those turnovers. So they've made it very difficult for Wake now in the half court, not giving up the easy basket.
Daniels looking inside. Here's Songalia. And he walked. 3:57 to go in the ball game. Wake Forest on top of Maryland. It's 85-81.
Hey, irishamase. Konnichiwa. Nani? Nani ka?
Looking for nail clippers.
La, 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 la.
Do you have nail clippers?
Sugee kuruma jya.
You know, nail clippers?
Clip.
Yeah. This is exactly what I need.
Rated E for everyone.
At BASF, we don't make the rain gear. We make it drier. We don't make the seat. We make it safer. We don't make the clothes. We make them cleaner. We don't make the bandage. We make it stick better. We don't make a lot of the products you buy. We make a lot of the products you buy better. BASF.
Bill Pito back in the studio as we again check in on Georgetown and Syracuse. Kevin Braswell here, under 5 minutes to go for the Hoyas. The running floater is up, and it is good. 61-55 in favor of Georgetown. And the hockey game for the Olympic gold. Team Canada leads the USA 2-1, second period.
Only 3:57 left. Wake leads Maryland by four. Another classic at Cole Fieldhouse. Let's take a look back. So many memories. Lefty Drizel. You can't think of this building without thinking of Lefty. And the three best players that he ever had, certainly on one team, are Buddy Lenny Elmore down in the corner. Cole, they have defeated six number one teams here. Only on-campus facility to host two Final Fours. Texas Western, Kentucky in 1966, a watershed event for college basketball and society as well. And Elvis Presley played here in 1974. Mouton has it tipped and throws it away. Wake Forest continuing to take advantage of Maryland mistakes at critical times.
Again, can't say it enough about the little things there. Once again, Maryland turns it over, gives Wake Forest an opportunity, but they get it back, and they do it by blocking out.
Juan Dixon in the lane, spun out. Howard, great hustle to the corner to save it.
Boy, and almost lost it. Again, that athleticism, got his balance and used his quick hands to grab it just before it hit the ground out of bounds.
Time becoming a factor now. 3:12. Hicks slashes in. Danilus got a hand on it, couldn't hold it. Faxton to play.
But they're bouncing around in that paint, aren't they?
Aren't they ever. Wilcox. Offensive rebound. Mouton with a tough, tough shot. And then Baxter commits a foul over the back. Good rebound by Dawson, who's done just about everything today, hasn't he?
He has certainly done the offensive things that they needed to do. And now he's contributing on the other end. But I'll tell you what, a thing I don't like with Byron Mouton, I love the hustle, but I didn't like the fact that he's under the basket 2 feet away.
Right.
He's got strength and size, and he winds up with a 10-foot jump shot as he fades away and misses everything. Again, the little things you got to focus on, and he's too good a player to make that mistake at this juncture.
Dawson has 27 points, misses the front end of a 1-1. Nearly stolen inside by Howard. Neither team taking advantage of opportunities right now. Gary Williams telling Blake what he wants him to do. Blake penetrates, kicks it back to Mouton. Dixon, wide open is Blake. Baseline. Nice dish to Wilcox. The value of Blake, it's a two-point game.
Just that little scoot along the baseline caught the defense flat-footed.
Steve Blake has a dozen assists in this ball game.
Again, watch Blake. Receives on the baseline, sees the defender rush him, and everybody has to come to Blake, and all Blake had to do is just pick out the guy he wanted to flush.
Tremendously aware. Only 2:14 to go. Still a two-point game.
The arm's still strong, but sometimes the pain's even stronger. So I grab control with Advil. Not Tylenol, not Aleve. Nothing's proven stronger or lasts longer than Advil.
You have the strength to get rid of pain. Take control. Take Advil.
In his new movie, Josh Hartnett is on a 40-day, 40-night dry spell. In ESPN's What a Dry Spell sweepstakes, it's easier on you. Log on to ESPN.com/contests and test your sports dry spell trivia. You can win a sports fantasy weekend. Look for 40 Days and 40 Nights in theaters March 1st.
85-83. Number 21, Wake Forest, trying to get a stranglehold on third place in the conference and bring Duke back into the championship picture with Maryland. Steve Blake now 671 career assists, a school record. He has been outstanding through his 3 years, just past Keith Gatlin, who was a wonderful, wonderful point guard here.
I'll tell you what, Steve Blake, old school. Again, you talk about pass first and look to make other people better. He knows his role out there. You know, that's a number that'll be etched in the minds of these folks when his time to move on comes.
I'm not sure if his dad here, but his dad drives back and forth from Miami Lakes, Florida all the time. And foul on Dawson. Dixon went for the steal, got a piece of it. Dawson commits the foul, trying to get it back. If you send Dixon to the line, it's automatic.
Well, when you put the ball up in the air like this, it's up for grabs. That's too long a pass to have to make. And with the quickness that Maryland displays in their pressure scheme, once the ball's up in the air for more than a second or two, you're going to have to expect it to be contested.
Juan Dixon shoots better than 90%. He hit all three this afternoon. He can get to 19 points and tie it at 85.
Well, couldn't come at a better time as far as Maryland's concerned. They've got some momentum. They now see that the pressure works. And Wake better expect it every time they inbound the ball.
Dixon with that great stroke, tied at 85. What a ball game. Nearly 15,000 on their feet. Songalia down the lane with a left hand. Songalia with a tip. Songalia with another shot. Danilus lost it. Maryland has it. Boy, that looked like a bad call. I don't think the official had any kind of an angle to make on that. They call one on Howard.
Well, right here, you take a look right there. Good fight. Good effort. Songalia getting beat up underneath, but, you know, again, it's been happening on both ends. But you're right, Mike. That foul, after all the contact inside, I think both coaches would say, you know what, let him play.
Yeah, that one was a little out of character for this whole thing. And Mouton will go to the line, 69% shooter, but he's hit 4 out of 5 today. Maryland has not had the lead in the second half until now. Gary Williams, who had arguably the greatest win of his career against Duke the other day, the day after his father passed away. What a courageous effort on his part. It's a one-point game. The boxing special coming up next. We're not done here. Maryland on top for the first time in a half. Howard. Wilcox with a rebound. Fouled by Howard. And Howard just lost his poise on that one after missing his shot. Just went in and went after Wilcox. But if you're going to send anybody to the free throw line, it might as well be the sophomore who only shoots 53%.
I was just going to say, at least potentially, the damage might get minimized. But in a situation like this, Josh Howard, with his athleticism, wonder why he's settling for a jump shot. He's had great success putting it on the floor and creating, but that time he settled and he paid.
Wilcox held to 2 points in the first half, has 8 in the second half. Make it 9. He also has 8 rebounds to go with it. He's working on a double-double in the second half alone.
But it just shows you how key he is to this Maryland attack. Makes it so much more difficult on the front line to contend with the Terps.
Missed the second. Mouton tips it out, trying to keep it alive. Howard brings it down. Goes baseline. Good decision to get it back outside to Hicks. Wake Forest wants a timeout, and Skip Prosser really upset.
And I think he called a timeout specifically to let the officials know how unbelievable he thought that call was.
Maryland on a 6-0 run. They have taken the lead here in the second half. Let's see what both teams have left. For Wake, Georgia Tech, and NC State. Maryland, Florida State, then they close it out the last game at Cole Fieldhouse against Virginia. You would think the way Virginia has struggled lately and the way Florida State has struggled lately, that if they win this one, they have a chance to go undefeated the rest of the way. Claim the ACC regular season championship by a game over Duke, and right now they are one game ahead of the Blue Devils. Wake is in third, but only one game ahead of the loss column against NC State. They play this evening against North Carolina. Huge possession here with 1:29 to go. Wilcox almost made the steal.
Craig Dawson, too nonchalant.
Yeah, he was.
In trying to throw that long pass. You got to see some people set some picks and come to the ball.
Dana loose. Now they'll find Hicks. Wake has not hit a field goal in 4 minutes. Hicks stolen by Blake. And now another jump ball, and the possession arrow gives it back to Wake. There is that possession arrow again. How is that fair?
But it evened out. You had one play on this end. And here Blake makes a good defensive play. And unfortunately doesn't get the benefit of it because of the tieout. On the other end, Wake makes a play, and they don't get the benefit of it. I'm not saying that I agree with it.
Right.
Unfortunately, the reason we don't have the jump ball is because the officials have never been able to throw it up properly. I think that's even more unfair.
Well, let's have a clinic.
Or let's get a machine, roll it out on the floor, like the shot, pitching machine.
The shot clock does not reset. Songalia in a double team. Dawson, nice dish to Danilus, but he lost it. Songalia, Hicks, shot clock at six. Hicks into Danilus, missed it, but tipped it in. Nice play by Danilus. Tied at 87.
And there's that word again, poise. Wake Forest could have fumbled that one away, and they hung in there tough.
The freshman stayed after it. 87-87.
Talk about the ball movement right here. Boy, Hicks didn't have many places to go with it. And Danilus stays with it. He missed it, held his position. Boy, you got a towel? It's getting wet in here, boy.
50.6 seconds to go. And you get the feeling Maryland needs to score on this trip. If they don't, Wake would have a chance to play for the last shot in the win.
Yeah, the way Maryland has been playing, though, you can expect them, once again, to explore inside out. You got to go to your two seniors right there, Juan Dixon and Lonnie Baxter. They've been in these situations before. You got a consummate ball handler in Steve Blake. They're going to be able to execute. It's just going to be a question of whether or not they can put the shot down.
They have 29 on the shot clock, 50.6 on the game clock. If they don't shoot within 15 seconds, the shot clock will be off.
So there's a little triangle right here. Having Blake at the point of it, always keeps somebody on the baseline to be able to feed Baxter when he gets position.
Shot clock at 10. Blake doubled up. Wilcox. Got it! Terps by two.
Pardon me, Mr. Sophomore tells me to keep my mouth shut. He can handle it. Chris Wilcox, big play.
Skip Prosser wants a timeout. 20.1 seconds left. His club down by two, but they have the basketball.
Well, again, Steve Blake, screen and roll. Nobody covers up quickly enough. And Wilcox goes to the basket strong. Once again, Blake with a tough pass. It wasn't a bounce pass. Had to lob it over the defenders. But we said, once again, he's a consummate ball handler. They were going to execute whatever they ran. It was just a question of making the shot.
Maryland is 22-3. They have never been 23-3 in school history. And this would be 13-1 in the conference. The 13 would match the most wins they've ever had with still two to go. And it would almost ensure them at least a share of the ACC title. Wilcox, 11 points after being held to a single bucket in the first half. And it comes down to the last 20 seconds. Hicks having trouble getting it in. Barely got it into Danilus. Blake's all over. Watch the clock. Hicks forced a shot. What was he thinking? And then Howard with a follow. And he's fouled. Holy cow. What was Hicks thinking of?
Hicks was looking to take the jumper, and quite honestly, I think he got fouled. It looked like he got hit on the wrist because the ball wouldn't have gone that short. And I think Maryland also, at least mentally, celebrated too soon. Watch him relax. The ball goes up short. Guys start to relax a little bit. Then they realize it's short, and they go after it. But Howard's the man on the spot.
Howard has hit only 2 out of 4 free throws. On the year, he is a 65% shooter. He will be going to the line with a chance to give Wake the lead with 10 seconds to go. This would be the fourth year Maryland would be undefeated at home. Would be. A lot of ifs left in this one.
But you know what? Again, Maryland was as surprised as we were on that shot by Hicks. And when Hicks, and again, I know based upon the trajectory of that ball and how short it was, he was hit on the wrist. No question about it. Officials didn't see it. But the Maryland players down low relaxed a little bit because they were surprised by the shot. And then you take a look at them go after it. Now watch, again, Blake right there. A little bit of ball, maybe a little bit of wrist. The two guys just bang into each other. Nobody blocks out Howard as everybody watched the ball.
Great awareness by Howard. Tied at 89. Wake with a free throw to come. Still plenty of time, though. 10.2 seconds on the clock. Maybe the watershed event for Maryland this year was that comeback at Virginia. They were left for dead down there. And somehow they made a brilliant comeback to win. They may look back at that at the end of this year, and that may tell them when everything started going perfectly. Howard has been tremendous off the bench for this club. 18 and 14 off the bench, playing with that high ankle sprain. This would give his team the lead.
Be interesting to see what Maryland does in the event that he misses. If they're going to run it, yes, they will.
Juan Dixon. Timeout with 1.3 seconds to go. And Gary Williams is saying that he tried to get a timeout early. Is that what he's saying? Or that Wake does not have any timeouts. If they don't, that's a technical foul. Shades of Michigan.
And Prosser knows it too. You can tell a resigned look on his face.
Oh, boy, what a way it would be to lose a game like this that way.
You take a Juan Dixon, takes it to the basket, gets as good a shot as you can get.
Howard calls time. The officials checking at the score table.
Now you got to wonder this. Was that even discussed in the huddle during the last timeout?
Right.
You got to tell these guys, you're out of timeouts, don't make the call.
There's always an assistant coach who's responsible for it. And Howard just feels awful. And Dixon, who is automatic. Juan Dixon with 20 points. It can be a 2-point game. And the Deacons are just shaking their heads. Dixon misses the second. 1.3 seconds to go. They put a tenth back on it. It will take a miracle.
And the miracle will be the first pass has to get somewhere close to half court to even have a shot at this.
Songalia, three-quarter court. Knocked away. Hicks fires at the buzzer. It would have counted had it gone. What an incredibly heartbreaking way for Wake Forest to lose this game. And Josh Howard is in tears. It would have gone to overtime had Howard merely gotten the rebound and held on to it. We would have gone to overtime 89-89. Incredible. 90-89. Maryland wins. That's it from College Park Boxing from Cincinnati is next. For Len Elmore and our entire ESPN crew, this is Mike Patrick. Thanks for watching, everybody. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.